Hello everyone, in this video we are going to talk about contrast bath. The principle of contrast bath therapy is to combine the effects of both hot as well as cold bath together. The bath is immersed alternatively in hot and cold water tanks. The temperature of hot water should be 40 to 45 degrees Celsius and the cold water from 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. The bath is first immersed in hot water and then in cold water and treatment is repeated thereafter. Method of application. First, the examination of skin and thermal sensitivity should be done. Two suitably sized baths are filled, the hot at 40 to 45 degrees Celsius and the cold at 15 to 20 degrees Celsius. Treatment usually starts and finishes with the immersion in the hot water. But if treatment starts with hot water and ends with hot water, it is for pain relief. And if we start with cold water and end with cold water, it is for edema. Immersion in hot water is for 3 to 4 minutes, while immersion in cold water is for 1 minute. This cycle is repeated for 3 to 4 times, so that the whole treatment time is 15 to 25 minutes. During the treatment, the hot water will cool and the cold water will be warmed, partly due to the transfer of warm or cold wet limb from one bath to the another. A thermometer should be available to monitor the water temperature. Physiological effects. The alteration in warm and cold water leads to vasodilatation and vasoconstriction at regular intervals. It leads to reduction in swelling. Frequent vasoconstriction and vasodilatation facilitate draining of metabolic waste product, which causes pain. The change in temperature leads to the change in sensory stimulus. This strong sensory stimulus acts to suppress the pain by means of gate mechanism and accounts for suppression of pain in many patients receiving this treatment. Indications: post-traumatic swelling, pain due to swelling, chronic inflammation, tight amputation stump, arthritis of peripheral joints, musculotendinous strain, and joint sprain. Contraindications: open wounds, recent hemorrhage, eczema, infection, skin allergy, hypo or hypersensitive skin, uncooperative patient, advanced peripheral vascular disease, diabetes, arterial insufficiency. Precautions: temperature should not be too high or too low, which is uncomfortable for the patient.